great. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Right now, we are just want us to just lift up our voices to heaven and begin to bless the name of the Lord. Let's give Him all the praise. He's worthy of our praise. Lift up your voice. Lift up your heart and just worship His name. Oh, Father, we bless you. Open your mouth and just give Him the glory. Open your mouth and just worship Him. Open your mouth and give Him praise. Worship the Lord. Worship Him. Give Him His holiness.
Oh, The better one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. I'm not a winner. More than victorious. I'm the head of his kingdom. Filled with the Holy Ghost. I rejoice in you.
Oh, yeah. Glory to Jesus. It's the second Sunday in the month of September 2020, and we've started our series last week Sunday on the habits of progressive people. Wonderful session, wonderful sharing time we had last week Sunday. And we're having Dr. Freeman in the house this morning. Dr. Freeman, I don't know how to describe him. He's a wonderful person, great soul. We were together at Olapsa Anambra University, and he was a campus fellowship pastor. I was also a campus fellowship pastor. His fellowship, my fellowship, and some other fellowships, we actually shook that campus. But Dr. Freeman is a fantastic person. It's been a while though that I saw him physically before now that we connected again. He's a great person in real estate business in Nigeria now. He's one of the top 10 disruptors in that line of business, and he's here to be a blessing to us. At that point in his life, he represented Nigeria on a global level for something, and maybe some of this he will be sharing with us today to the glory of God. So after this video introduction that we are about to get now, the voice and the face after that video introduction will be that of Dr. Freeman. Dr. Freeman will be a blessing to us. Get your notepad, get your pen. Something awesome is about to break forth from this service today. You're about to get all those habits that progressive people actually form and cultivate, that always move them from one point to another, moving upwardly in their life, that made them to be upwardly mobile. So don't miss it. Are we ready now? Let's have the video introduction of the
ladies and gentlemen, welcoming the speaker for today's service in the person of Dr. Freeman Oshonuga.
Dr. Freeman Oshonuga is a multi-award-winning real estate entrepreneur, seasoned public speaker, humanitarian, and medical doctor.
Dr. Freeman Oshonuga is a global leader who effortlessly dons many caps and has made easy meal of successfully being a medical doctor, real estate broker, humanitarian, international public speaker, and a successful entrepreneur, all in his stride.
He currently leads At Loyalty Business Network. At Loyalty Business Network is Nigeria's first and biggest independent real estate network marketing platform with over 20,000 trained real estate brokers.
Mention the top 10 successful real estate entrepreneurs in Nigeria. His name is somewhere there. So join me with Jesus' joy in your heart this morning
and make special libraries assemblies welcome to Dr. Freeman Oshonuga, being his first time in Libraries Assembly, the Chief Executive Officer of Our Loyalty Business Network.
Dr. Freeman Oshonuga.
Hello, I'm Dr. Freeman Oshonuga. I'm a multiple award-winning real estate entrepreneur. I'm a medical doctor, an international public speaker, and an accomplished author. I'm so grateful to be invited by the leadership of Lifebridge Assembly to be having this topic with us today. I'm speaking on the habits of progressive people. This is such an exciting topic for me because it gives us an insight into how progressive people became who they are. The various successful people that we look out for, that we are inspired by their story, their life and achievements. This theme makes us know that these people were made by their habits. So, who are successful people? Successful people are the various people that we have in various spheres of life that are doing fantastically well. We constantly and consistently read about their strides in the media, in the newspaper. We are inspired by the stories of many of these people that we admire, how they rose from grass to grace, how they became successful from being given birth to in abject poverty. But when we now study their habits gives us the secret to becoming who they are now, you know, and if we can model after the positive things in their habit and lifestyle, we also can recreate their success in our personal life. So successful people are the people, progressive people are the people that we admire, people that make the headlines for positive reasons, people that are successful, they have a lot of money to fulfill the God-given dreams that God has given them. They have a fantastic family. There is love and harmony in their homes. They are thriving in their career, in their business, in their ministry. And these are the people, this all encapsulates what our desires are. So when we now look into their habit gives us that insight. So what are habits? The popular saying about habit that I love so much is that we make our own habits and then our habits make us. My mentor says that whatever you can consistently do for 21 days will successfully become your habit. So habits are the thing that you do repeatedly. After you do them repeatedly, they now take control of your life. So you choose your habits, but your habits determine your outcome, your habits determine your destiny. So if you have bad habits are limiting you to becoming your best. Bad habits are limiting you to achieve your goals. Bad habits are going to stop you from becoming the best and all that God has for you. But great habits are the things we should all develop in various aspects of our life, in our finances, in our prayer work, in our worship, in our conversation with God, in our interpersonal relationships, in our dreams, in our aspirations, in our career, in our businesses, in our ministry. We should build up habits, positive habits, habits that help us to achieve our goals and to achieve all that God has desired for us to have. So quickly today, I'm going to be talking about 7 most important habits of progressive people. I'm going to be talking a lot from my experience and the stories, the inspiring stories that I have had. So what's the number one habit of progressive people that we must all emulate today? Number one is the habit of goal setting. The habit of goal setting. Every successful person you see, you know, that is thriving, they do so because for every time, for every phase of their life, for every phase of their endeavor, there is always a goal they are working towards. Progressive people are not haphazardly doing things. They are not living life based on wishes and wants. They are not living life losing control to circumstances to determine the outcome of their day. Progressive people live by setting goals for themselves. Progressive people live by having clearly set objectives per time. This is the last quarter of this year. We are entering the last quarter of this year, and as it is, this year can still be a successful year for somebody by doing a review of the previous month of this year and setting new goals, making it a fresh start. Looking at the most important aspect of your life, your finances, your career, your academics, your relationship, and setting new goals. What are goals? Goals are clearly set objectives that are time-bound, that take you from where you are to where you want to be. So, in setting your goals, it is important that you know that goals are the vehicles that take you from where you are to the next place that you want to be. And it's extremely important that we do this intentionally and strategically. Let me give an example. Let's say, for example, you might even be a football fan. Say Manchester United is playing against Chelsea Football Club, and they have all the stars in this match. Then the referee blows the whistle. The midfielders are doing the best they are doing. They are attacking your team, but now there's no goal post. I mean, just imagine a football match, an European League match, without goal post, with all the stars in that match. Of course, there's going to be total confusion. the match is going to be, the match is not going to be productive, and it's going to end in total disappointment. So lives, people that live their day-to-day affairs without having clearly cut goals, will be going about their days without having any metric for measuring success. They will be living without direction. Life will be purposeless. Life will be meaningless. So, number one habit of highly progressive people is that they set goals for themselves every time. Goals for their personal life, goals for their health, goals for their spiritual life, goals for their finances, for family, setting goals and clearly being driven by this objective to become the best. Now, a goal must be SMART. I'm sure we all know that a goal must be specific, a goal must be measurable, the goal you want to set must be achievable, it must be realistic, and it must be time-bound. So let's say, for example, that you are a business person. All through this, from January to August this year, your business has not been doing fine, so you do a review and you want to set new goals, new business goals. By this, you want to say, oh, all through January to August, we attended to a total of 90 clients. Oh, for the remaining part of this year, we want to attend to, you know, you have to be specific. Oh, 120 new clients. So that goal is specific. Then it must be measurable. How are you going to measure this? How are you going to? So you must set goals that can measure, not unrealistic white elephant projects. It must be measurable. It must be achievable. Because it is your goal, you are not setting your goal to impress anybody. You are setting your goal for yourself, so that you can achieve your goal and become a better person. So you set for yourself realistic, achievable goals. And then you set a time bound for these goals. I want to achieve these goals between this time and this time. So once you have done this, you are starting this habit of progressive people. Now, the number two habit of progressive people that I want to talk about is a vision. Progressive people are constantly and consistently picturing themselves in the future that they desire. Progressive people are constantly and consistently creating the world of their dreams in pictures. You see, you cannot feature in a future that you cannot picture in your mind. You cannot have a future, you cannot have a dream that you cannot clearly see in your mind. And I'm sorry to break this bad news to you. If the consistent pictures that you see in your mind are pictures of doom, are pictures of disappointment, these are going to be your daily experiences. If the pictures you see are the pictures of not enough, if the pictures you see are the pictures of want, lack, disappointment, failure, these are going to be your constant and your consistent realities. So what are you going to do? Our mind works like a computer, inputs and outputs. So change the information that is going in into your head, in into your mind, so that what will be the output of your mind will be different. So cut off the bad news, cut off the dirty gists on social media, cut off any vibe that is negative, so that you can, and then intentionally feed your mind with the pictures of your dream. Intentionally feed your mind with the pictures of your dream cars. See yourself driving your dream cars every time. That to do that will cost you zero naira, and you need nobody's permission to do that. So see, constantly picture yourself living the life of your dream, having a very great time with your husband, having a fantastic time with your family, being celebrated at work, always see yourself having a fantastic life. If you consistently see yourself like this, your life is moving in this direction. So there's a popular saying that your life moves in the direction of your most dominant thoughts, and your thoughts and what you see, they go in the same direction. So successful people are always seeing themselves in a bright future. They are always creating the world of their dreams, their future, with their mind. They are always painting great pictures. They are always creating great pictures. You might say they are daydreaming, but they started to daydream till they become successful, and they continue to daydream until their success becomes bigger and bigger. But people that are not successful say, oh, why should I daydream? Why can't I just face reality? If you face reality, you cannot create a better future for yourself. Now, the number three thing successful people do, progressive people do, is that they believe. You have to believe in yourself. You have to believe in the beauty of your dreams. You have to believe in the possibility of you having success. You have to believe in the possibility of your wildest dreams coming to pass. Nobody might give you this favor, but you owe yourself this favor to believe in yourself, to believe in the beauty of your dreams. Do not allow the negative news in this country to kill the beauty of your dreams. You have to do what? You have to believe. You have to believe. The biggest limitations that we face in our lives are the barriers that we put in our mind. I remember the story of this powerful magician, this powerful watch locker. He boasted that there is no lock in the world. There is no that he cannot unlock. There is no padlock. There's no door lock that he cannot unlock. So there was this newly built jail. So this watch locker, this magician, approached the authorities and he boasted to them that if they lock him up in their most difficult jail cell, in their most locked jail cell, in 30 minutes, he will come out of that jail. So the jail authorities accepted his challenge. Oh, you want to unlock our jail? If you're lucky, you want to unlock our jail and go out freely. They accepted his challenge. And at the day that was set, he majestically rolled into the prison. After he rolled into the prison, he was put into this particular jail cell and they shut the door of the jail to him there. Now, as they shut the door of the jail, he got down behind the scene, and behind his belt, he has hit a metal, a tiny metal. So he brought out this secret metal, and that was his plan, that with this secret metal, he would be able to unlock the jail padlock and come out in minutes. But 1 minute turned to 3 minutes, to 5 minutes, to 30 minutes, attempt after attempt, he could not unlock the padlock. He could not unlock the jail cell. He could not unlock himself from the jail cell. And after several attempts, he gave up trying. And as he gave up, he collapsed against the door. As he collapsed against the door flung open. The door flung open and he was very shocked. He was shocked because here is this particular door that he has been trying effort. He has been putting a lot of effort. He has been using his strength, his witty intentions. He has been using all his wisdom, all his craftiness, all his skill to unlock. but the door was never locked. But in his mind, the door was firmly locked. And my point to us today is this. Most of the limitations that we have, most of the limitations that we're experiencing, most of the things stopping you from progressing are in your mind. They don't exist. As a career person, how many of the biggest doors in your career have been knocked? How many biggest doors? What are the biggest doors in your career? And how many of those doors have been knocked? Because it is the door you knock that will be opened unto you. How many biggest business attempts have you done? How many great achievements have you attempted? If you don't attempt them, they will not come to you. So what is stopping you from attempting them is because in your mind, something is limiting you. There's a voice in your mind telling you, we don't do things like this. There's a voice in your mind telling you, you are too small. There's a voice in your mind telling you, you don't meet up. There's a voice in your mind telling you, this hotel, you cannot go and have lunch in this 5-star hotel because it was not made for you. There's a voice in your head telling you, you are second class. But until you silence all of those voices, until you remove all of those limitations, you will not be on the next level. You will not move to the next level. You will not achieve your dreams. So, progressive people believe. Progressive people believe they can be the best. Progressive people believe they can achieve their dreams. Progressive people believe that they can have all that they desire. And just by believing, that's the beginning. That's the starting point to achieving your dream. So say no to all of those voices that are telling you you cannot. Why? Because you can. The doors are not locked. Just knock. Just open the doors. Just open the doors. And don't open small doors. Knock on big doors. Some doors, when you get there, they will open by themselves. But because you are limited, you will not even go close. Some doors, when you knock, they will open them for you. Some doors, you knock, they don't open. You open it, it opens. And some doors, you now pull them down. But if you don't break down the limitation from your mind, you will not become successful. So, number four habit of highly successful people that I want to talk about is successful people constantly and consistently push themselves beyond limits. You see, success is never achieved in the comfort zone. Success is never achieved on the platter of gold. Success is never delivered to people who reside in their comfort zone. Success only comes to people who leave their comfort zone every time. To achieve new things, to become progressive, to have new heights of success, of achievement, you need to constantly push yourself. The best you had yesterday was good for yesterday, but it's not good for today. The best of your achievements can be better. You can be better. You can be a better husband. You can be a better son. You can be a better father. You can be a better banker. You can be a better lawyer. Progressive people are always looking for the room to improve. Because the biggest room in the world is the room for improvements. You can always improve. I can always improve. I remember this story of a very wealthy king that had only one daughter. This wealthy king wanted to make sure that his daughter was married to a brave man. So he called a feast of all the young men in the city and he told them, look, my daughter is getting married. One of you will marry my daughter. Whoever that person is that marries my daughter, I will give him half of my wealth. Oh, all the men of the city were so excited and they were all jubilating, saying that, oh, let me marry the king's daughter. But the king told them there was a contest that they all need to do. Very simple contest. Just to swim from one end of his swimming pool to the other end. Whoever does that successfully will marry his daughter. Fantastic. Very simple task. All the young men, they flung open their shirts, they threw away their clothes, and they were ready to dive into the swimming pool. But the king told them, hold on. Then some of his aides, the aides of the king, brought a pool of blood. Now, the king dipped his finger in that bowl of blood and dropped some drops of blood in that swimming pool. Then different crocodiles that were in that pool just came out. So all these young men that wanted to dive into that swimming pool suddenly realized that this is not an ordinary swimming pool, but this swimming pool is filled with crocodiles. So all of them started to retreat. But before we could know what was happening, one guy dived in. While we were looking for this guy, what happened? Somebody's in the pool. Before we realized what happened, the guy was out on the other end of the pool. And everybody was happy. Wow, such a great, brave guy. The king approached him. How were you able to do that? I'm very impressed with you. So you will marry my daughter. I will give you half of my wealth. Brave man. But the guy was having none of it. And the only thing he said was, who pushed me? Who pushed me? Who pushed me into this swimming pool? So what happened? While everybody wanted to run away from the swimming pool because of the crocodiles, somebody actually pushed him. But because he was pushed, he swam out of the swimming pool and he won the prize and he achieved all of his potential. So you today, I'm telling you, if you have nobody to push you, you can push yourself. Until you push yourself to overcome all of your fears, your wildest dreams will always remain dreams. Until you push yourself daily, overcoming your limitations, overcoming your trials, not giving up, not allowing discouragement to set in. As you continue to push daily, you will achieve your goals. So the number five habit of progressive people is progressive people consistently commit to a life of personal and career development. Progressive people are always learning new skills. Progressive people are always reading a book. Progressive people are always studying new material. Progressive people are always talking about new concepts, new ideas, better ways of doing things. Progressive people, great minds don't discuss people. Great minds, ordinary people discuss people and events. Ordinary people discuss controversies and challenges in the country. Great minds are interested in conversation about ideas, strategies for doing things, for making things better. The number six habits of highly successful and progressive people is risk. Progressive people have a very good appetite for risk. If you continue to play it safe all your life, you will never have the experience of victory. If you take the biggest risk in the world, is not taking any risk at all. As a businessman, I'm always asking myself, this risk I want to take now, is that the biggest risk I've taken this year? When I take that one and I overcome it, I look for new things to do, new territories to conquer in business, and I'm always asking, is this the biggest way I can do it? Is this the best way I can do it? Is this the most productive way to engage with this project? Why? Until you are comfortable taking intelligent, calculated risk, you will remain where you are. So, progressive people have habits of taking intentional, calculated, well-thought-out risks. Then the last but not the least habit of progressive people that I want to talk about is a positive attitude to failure. It's okay to fail. It's okay for your project. The project you have started is okay if that project is not successful. It's okay. Don't be emotional about a project not coming through. Don't be emotionally attached. If you have a project, if it's successful, fantastic. If it's not successful, give glory to God, learn the lessons from there, and move on to your next project. So it's okay to fail. It's okay to attempt something and not get it. But you have learned something in that process. I love to say that the faster you fail, the closer you get to success. I love to say that because I know it's true that the more you fail, the closer you are to success. And failures are the building blocks for success. Most successful people that you know, they have failed more than they have become successful. But the fantastic thing about success is, even if you have failed 9 times, the 10th time that you succeed will wipe off all the history, all the pain, all the background of the failures that you have. So if you have failed in your project, don't take it to heart. Don't take it personal. Don't get emotional with it. Take failure as an event, dissociate yourself from it, learn from it, just yourself, and then get up and get on your new project. Thank you for having me, and I'm so grateful. I hope you have been able to pick out one or two thoughts from this teaching. Thank you.
Wow, Pastor Freeman, thank you. That was huge. That was massive. That was massive. Thank you for creating time to be a blessing to people in Abeokuta here. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. A bit of progressive people. That was wonderful, sir. That was wonderful. So hope you have been blessed, guys. Doctor really opened our eyes to a lot of things, and I believe transformation have begun, and we'll have testimonies after now. So next week Sunday is another time in God's presence. We'll be having my mentor of about 15 years, TPL Tony Anide, one-time commissioner in Lagos State, not a politician, but was selected as a technocrat to bring professionalism to physical planning and urban development in Lagos State, which God helped him to actually do. You will not want to miss the session with him. You will not want to miss the session with him. I'm ready to be blessed by what God has put in his heart and through his mouth for us next week Sunday. Please get ready, invite your friends. Invite your friends to this space as we get blessed together, as we form habit as progressive people ordained by God to be a progressive people. So if you are watching with us for the very first time in Light Breeze Assembly, this is Light Breeze Assembly, and our vision here is to raise a people for destiny fulfillment. And our guests, our first timers in Light Breeze Assembly, we call them very important person, VIP. So if you are a VIP in today's service, there is a form attached to this video. Please fill the form and we'll contact you immediately. So we'll see you next week Sunday. I want to pray for you. This week, the word of God will have full expression in your life. In the name of Jesus, I release grace of God over your business. I release the grace of God over your career. I release the grace of God over all your endeavors. Anywhere you appear this week, favor will speak for you. Anywhere you appear this week, grace will speak for you. Anywhere you appear this week, doors will open for you on their own accord. In the name of Jesus, this September shall be the September to remember in your life forever, and you will have testimonies to show for it. At the end of this month, you will dance and you will celebrate God's faithfulness in the name of Jesus. God bless you. See you next week Sunday. I love you.